Welcome to another episode of Ask Your Excel Question. And this is our fifth episode in the series. And in this video, we will learn how to highlight weekends in a calendar dynamically, where you can actually change the weekends. So for example, if we have some setup like this, where we have all the dates in the month that we have chosen, then you can just choose Sunday as weekend, and then the Sundays get highlighted. And if you choose, you know, uncheck Saturday, Saturdays don't get highlighted. You can actually make it work for any month, whether I choose June, again, all the Sundays will get highlighted. So in this video, we will learn how to implement this. So we will start with already an existing setup, but in the previous videos, you can check out how we can establish this weekend checkbox control. In one of the previous videos, we can also see how we can implement this dropdown and also create a calendar of dates automatically. So all of these formulas are explained in the previous videos. I will put the links to those. I'm not going to go over them again in this video, but let's just start with assuming we already have like a true or false kind of thing for each of the weekdays. I'm going to select all these cells and I'm just going to select, mark them or name them weekends. And this is how we are going to call this set of cells L underscore WKNDS. And the next thing we are going to do is to show the day of the week. So for example, I'm just going to write a very simple formula to say equals this cell, and it's going to put up something like this. I'm going to double click, but only fill without formatting because I don't want the formatting there. So I'm going to change the formatting of these dates to actually, let's go to custom, and I'm going to type in DDD, which will show us the day of the week. That's what I want. And center them. Okay, so now we have the dates, and if I change this, it's going to automatically show what the weekday is. Okay, now in order to implement the highlighting or the colors, what we're going to do is to select these cells and then do conditional formatting, new rule. And the rule that we're going to implement is a formula rule. So I'm going to click that, and then I'm going to write a formula which is index of L underscore weekends, which is the name that we gave to these cells, comma, and which should we check for depending on which cell you are in. So let's say, for example, I am in I6. So I will type in I6 and close that. So what this formula is going to do is to go to this list of values, and then it's going to go and find specifically the day of the week for the specific date. So, and then we'll just do some formatting, and then we'll see the results. So it'll make it more clear. So I'm going to use a white font and a green fill. So it'll appear like this. I'm going to hit OK. That's it. So this is the formula to do that. And what it is doing is, each of the dates here, the weekday function will actually return a number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So for example, to illustrate this, I'm gonna do weekday this. So if you do this, it's gonna say 5 because Thursday is 5 and 1 is Sunday. So Sunday, Monday, 2, so 1 through 7. And the critical part here is that we are using the default order. There are many different ways of numbering these weekdays. So if you choose the parameter 2, Monday will be 1. If you choose 3, Monday will be 0. So there are different ways of implementing it. I use the default method, which is Sunday through Saturday. Sunday is 1. And that is precisely the reason why we set up the weekend choices here in terms of starting from Sunday. And so if you change this order in your implementation, then your weekday formula function also has to change. If you keep the default, then it has to be Sunday through Saturday for this formula to work. So if you add another checkbox here of Saturday, now all the Saturday and Sunday both will be there. So if I uncheck Sunday, Sunday will not be displayed anymore. And April, you can change the month. It doesn't matter. You can change the year. It'll still work. So very simple implementation. All you need to keep in mind is that we are implementing a simple conditional formatting rule, which is using the index function and the weekday function. Hope this video was useful. And if you like more videos like these, please post them in the comments. If you have any questions or suggestions, please post them in the comments as well. And I'll see you all in the next episode of Ask Your Excel Question. Thank you very much for watching.